Obviously, Ashley, as you know, people have been not only been coming out to the courthouse and in the courtroom or watching it on television, but on the internet and specifically on Twitter, this has been going nuts. And this lady here is the queen tweeter, Kinsey Schofield. She's got 250,000 Twitter followers, and you've been in this courtroom every single day, keeping people abreast of this. But more importantly, you're getting a lot of feedback. What is it about this case that had people so just enthralled?
Well, you know, they can relate to this case. A lot of girls can relate to somebody not wanting them back. So I think that began the chaos. But it's the sex, it's the religion, it's all of those things that people become engrossed in. It's almost like a soap opera.
And yeah, and Kinsey, Ashley, normally tweets about Justin Bieber and other things. It's what? True. And you're here. It doesn't make sense.
It doesn't come together. I just was enthralled with Travis. Travis had so much potential. He was a guy on the rise, and this woman wanted him to be hers and no one else's. And again, it's like that Lifetime movie, you get sucked into it, and that's really what got me involved.
All right, and jurors, as we've been saying, Ashley, are on a lunch break here when they were headed to the elevator, according to Casey Wyan, our correspondent up on the fifth floor of the courthouse here. He said that you could tell that they were relieved that they had come to a decision. Their work may not be finished if they come to a first-degree murder verdict, then that kicks in the next phase here, aggravation, and then the penalty phase. So while they may not be completely done, they seem to be relieved that they have gotten over this hurdle, and we'll find out what they decided in just a bit. Ashley.